That we're going to switch gears a little bit here, and this is going to be directed at you, Mr. Kennedy, first. It's an email question. This one is from Suzanne in Deerfield, who says, I would like a clear response from the candidates on their stance on the Northern Pass project. I would really appreciate an I support it or I will do everything in my power to stop it.
If it's one or the other, I'm not there, and I apologize, but I tell you that I'm not a big advocate for Northern Pass. To even consider it, though, there has to be a confirmation that we benefit from the utility, and that hasn't been clearly indicated yet, that there will be some renovation to the existing infrastructure, which is degrading, that the property would be taken through eminent domain, that the lines will have an alternative route and buried using state right-of-ways or whatever, and that the key one is that we get our guys engaged with the project, our guys within the state employed, our workers employed. And there's no clear indication that anything that I've just said will be an attribute of Northern Pass, because they're going to bring in their own workers. We aren't going to gain any benefit from the utility. It's going to be pushed out of state. They're not going to renovate the infrastructure. So I think that's almost by de facto a no on Northern Pass.
Let's move it down the line, Mrs. Cilley.
The Northern Pass project, as you know, is an extremely contentious issue, not only up in the North Country, but all the way down into the Southern Tier. So I have said we don't allow the taking of our citizens' land, whether they have been on their property for 6 months or six generations. We do not allow the sale of our skyscapes. We don't allow to trade off, one type of job for another, and we are not a conduit from here to there. I oppose the plan as proposed. That said, when other states have been faced with very similar issues, they have found a way to get to yes by burying it. That has not been a fully explored option. It has been done in Maine, New York, Pennsylvania. I think that still is an open question as to whether it can be done effectively, cost-effectively. But the question actually starts in the wrong place. We need an energy plan for the state of New Hampshire. And we look at all of these things, not in the context of something that's best for our citizens and best for our businesses. We look at them individually without a context of a plan. So I would start there.
Ms. Hassan.
Well, I was just up in the North Country this week and reminded of what a spectacular state we live in. Our natural resources are important for our quality of life, but also for our tourism economy. We also, though, need to lower energy costs in New Hampshire, and we need to make sure, as we did in the state Senate, that we are providing incentives for homegrown alternative energy. I opposed the first Northern Pass proposal because it didn't honor the views of the communities where the towers were going to be situated, because it allowed for eminent domain for private profit, something I oppose, and I'm glad we worked to limit while I was in the state Senate. And we need, for any new Northern Pass proposal, it needs to respect the views of the communities. It needs to make sure that New Hampshire has access to the power and would gain something from the project. We need to look at burying the lines, and as governor, I will make sure that we do a very rigorous review of any proposal that comes forward.
So, Suzanne from Deerfield, there doesn't seem to be a yes or no answer there.